This means the diseases which transfer from one person to another by certain pathogens. So pathogens means the causative agent which carry the disease from one person to another. So these may be bacteria, virus, protozoans, helminths and fungus, etc. Mostly the pathogens are the parasites. Parasites, you learn about, read about the parasite in your plus one class also. They depend upon host body. They may be live in the body of the host or on the body of the host. When they live in the body, they are called as endoparasite. When they live on the body, they are called as ectoparasite. Mostly the pathogens are ectoparasites. Because when they are endocytes, they need to adopt the life within the environment of the body of the host. Means, for example, the pathogen enter the gut. It must know the way of surviving in the stomach at low pH, resistance to the various enzymes that is present in the stomach. So that's why the endoparasites need to adopt the life of the within the environment of the host. So we start with our first bacterial diseases, that is typhoid. So the causative agent for the typhoid is Salmonella typhi. It enters the small intestine through contaminated water and food and migrates to another body organ through blood. So that is typhoid. The symptoms of the typhoid are high fever, weakness, stomach pain, constipation, headache. And it is confirmed by the vital test, but it can be prevented by proper community sanitations and it can be controlled by certain antibiotics. So that is all about the typhoid. The causative agent is Salmonella. And it enters through the small intestine, through contaminated food and water. And the symptoms are high fever, stomach pain, constipation, headache. And it can be controlled by the proper sanitations and the antibiotic dose. Now the second bacterial disease is pneumonia. The causative agent is Streptococcus pneumoniae. It infects the alveoli of the lungs. As you read about the lungs respiratory system in your previous plus one class. So these alveoli, they get filled with the fluid, leads to the problem in the breathing and respiration. And its infection spread by the inhalation of the droplets by the infected person. Now the symptoms are fever, chill, cough, headache. And but in severe cases, lips and the fingers turns bluish. Some other common bacterial diseases are plague, diphtheria, dysentery, etc. So today we learn about the two types of bacterial diseases, typhoid and pneumonia. And also learn about what do you mean by health, how the good health can be obtained, and how we can maintain our health. So this is all about our today bio lecture. In the last, I give some assignment related to this topic that we done. These questions, you have to complete this assignment in your bio notebook. And I give you some second assignment also, that is our chapter reproduction in organism that we done. So and the topic is asexual reproduction. So these questions given in your assignment, you should have to complete it in your bio notebook. So that is all about the today bio class. Have a nice day.